Shavua Tov, Gedvach, Shabbos Kodesh, opened up the Ben Ish Chai. Ben Ish Chai is Chus Egan Aleinu, one of the great Rabbanim of the East. Yeah, I think there's the, not so long ago, I think he died in the 1920s. One of the greatest giants, Sephardic giants, but also someone that was halachic, Kabbalistic. Is buried, if I'm not mistaken, I think still in Baghdad, but I'm not sure. To go for a trip one day, hopefully before Mashiach comes. But the Ben Ish Chai writes on tzitzis, and I was so excited that I felt that this is something not even the talisman knows about. A Tana de Be'elio. Listen to this incredible Tana de Be'elio, and it just happened to be that the Rav Shem helped us open up on Shabbos Kodesh to this Tana de Be'elio. Really an eye-opener how special the mitzvah of tzitzis is, but specifically for Shabbos. You know, Shabbos, sometimes we're different people, we're different Yidden. I once heard such a beautiful explanation that Shomer Shabbos, what's a Shomer Shabbos? So the simple understanding is someone that keeps Shabbos. What does keep Shabbos? He makes sure that he doesn't do the wrong thing. But really, there's something so much deeper about what it means to be a Shomer Shabbos. And this is actually based on the Nesiv HaShalom, the Slanema. He says, Shomer Shabbos, Rashi says, when it comes to Yaakov Avinu, Ve'oviv Shomar es Adavar. Yaakov Avinu was Shoma, Rashi says, Yeshev Metzape. He's anticipating, he can't wait. A Shoma Shabbos, a real Shoma Shabbos, which Obi Zeich to be, is already Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday. We can't wait for Shabbos. Not just because the phone is going to be off. That already Friday, by Chatzos, the Yidden, that would sit with a tie and suit and ready for Shabbos. And not from a halachic point of view, because Shabbos is Shabbos. Shabbos is so special. Our clothing are different. Our neshama is different. Like we've discussed in the past, different levels, the neshama expands. There's more room to be able to connect. Says the Ben Ish Chai from the Tana de Be'elio, we know the parasha was speaking about, the end of the parasha was speaking about Mekoshesh Eitzim, the guy that was Mechal Shabbos. And he itself is a fascinating personality. There's a dispute if you're allowed to even mention who he was, because he really did it l'shem shemayim. But in any case, right then afterwards, you have the parsha of tzitzis. What's the connection? Says the Tana de Be'elio. The Rebbein Shem turned to Moshe Rabbeinu. He said, why do you think he was Mechal Shabbos? Moshe Rabbeinu said, I don't know. It's not a good question. It's got the Torah in the Midbar. They knew that there's a God. So there's different answers, but Moshe Rabbeinu in the Tana de Be'elio says, I don't know Hashem, which is also a lesson in itself. I don't know. Tell me why. Shem says, because during the 6 days of the week, a person is wearing tefillin. A man is wearing tefillin. A woman has her natural tefillin. She doesn't have to even wear tefillin. Consciously, we're connected to the Rebbein Shem. We have a reminder. Says the Rebbein Shem, Shabbos, he's not wearing tefillin. The Mekoshesh, this person, he wasn't wearing tefillin. There was nothing to remind him. So the Rebbein Shem told Moshe Rabbeinu, would say, go out, give them the mitzvah of tzitzis. Fascinating. This is the source, according to Daniel, of why we got the mitzvah tzitzis. Comes out from this Tana de Be'elio that besides the special, how special the mitzvah tzitzis is, as we mentioned during the week, but Shabbos Kodesh, even as a time, sometimes Shabbos Kodesh will be more relaxed. Yeah, tzitzis. Tzitzis is something that protects us on Shabbos. It's special to Shabbos. It's a special clothing to Shabbos. We know our clothing has to be different than Shabbos. It's because our neshama is different than Shabbos. And that's a special mitzvah of tzitzis and the connection. So that in itself is such a beautiful, beautiful style, idea about Shabbos and tzitzis. Mitzvah Hashem, this week we're going to go a little bit deeper. And especially with the topic that we started, which I think is something people thank me for speaking about. I don't know, I myself don't know. Do you know the chilbit and the exact, the history? Do your kids know the history of CBT, of cannabis, of what is good, what is bad, because the streets are going to be flooded. Shabbos Kodesh, I'm sitting next to Ayid that has a store, sells only CBT products, which is basically Bli Neder, the chiluk we're going to discuss, but so important to understand the distinction and the purposes. So this way we're educated, and we know what's going to bring us a connection, what's going to be a mitzvah, which is a connector, and what Chas V'Shalom is an aveira, where a person becomes void, when a person ends up going in the wrong direction. Yiratzon, we should be zeicher this week, should be an enlightening week, a week that we could feel so much connection to the Rebbein Shalom. Hatzlacha to everyone.